Dear students, in this video, I am going to discuss about physical properties of minerals depending on state of aggregation. In this, we will study cleavage, fracture, and hardness. Cleavage. What is cleavage? Tendency of crystallized minerals to part or split in parallel planes along definite directions of least atomic or molecular cohesion, yielding smooth surfaces. Cleavage is tendency of crystallized minerals to part or split. If the minerals are having cleavage, we can split or part into the different pieces with the help of cleavages. If the cleavages are easily, we can split into two pieces. That is called as cleavages. We can split it in parallel planes along definite directions. In the particular direction, we can split. Cleavage planes are parallel to crystal faces and occur in one, two or more sets intersecting perpendicularly or obliquely. Cleavages are described according to their number, direction and intersection of sets of cleavage planes. Bezel cleavages. Only one set of parallel to bezel planes. Only one set of parallel bezel cleavage. Cleavage is absent, present is called as bezel plane. The best example is beryl and mica. Students, you can see on the screen the mica mineral picture is shown, is visible. These mica mineral is having cleavages. Those are belongs to basal, BASAL cleavages, basal cleavages. These mica minerals are having one set of parallel planes. Second is prismatic cleavages. The best example for prismatic cleavage is hornblende, orthoclase, augite, gypsum. These are the best example for prismatic cleavage. This is a orthoclase sample. So what is prismatic cleavages? Two sets intersecting mutually perpendicular or obliquely is called as prismatic cleavages. Two sets intersecting mutually perpendicular is called as prismatic cleavages. You can see in this orthoclase, you can split the mineral in two direction. Is called as prismatic cleavages. And the next one is the cubic cleavages. The best example for cubic cleavage is galena. The black part, the black metallic shining, the mineral which is shining with the metallic with in black color, that is the galena. Galena is in crystal form. So the cubic cleavage. What is cubic cleavage? Three sets mutually perpendicular to each other. When the mineral shows cube or crystal that has three sets of mutual perpendicular to each other, cleavage, we can split in three direction, is called as cubic cleavage. The best example for cubic cleavage is galena, pyrite, fluorite. Here on screen you can see the galena mineral. And the fourth one is rhombohedral cleavage. The best example for rhombohedral cleavages is calcite and dolomite. So what is rhombohedral cleavages? Three sets intersecting at an angle. There will be an angle where the sets are intersecting. Number of sets are intersecting is called as rhombohedral cleavages. Three sets intersecting at an angle is called as rhombohedral cleavages. Best example is calcite and dolomite. Next is fracture, breakage pattern of minerals in directions other than cleavages. See, the cleavage is different. We can split into two pieces along the cleavage planes. But these are the fractures. We can break into two pieces, minerals break into two pieces in other direction other than the cleavages is called as fracture. Fracture is described according to the breakage pattern, that is appearance of the broken surface. First one is even fracture, second one is uneven fracture, third one is conchoidal fracture, fourth is the Hackley, and the fifth is earthy fracture. These are the different types of fracture: even fracture, uneven fracture, conchoidal fracture, Hackley fracture, and the last one is earthy fracture. So what is even fracture? Even fracture, breaking with smooth, almost plain surfaces. You can see the plane surfaces, like in orthoclase, you can see the plane surfaces. This is called as even. Even means surface. If you break the mineral, that will be maintain their plane surfaces. Is called as even fracture. Uneven fracture, breaking with rough, irregular surfaces. So hornblende, augite, and the others, okay, some minerals that shows uneven fracture on the surface. That is uneven fracture. Conchoidal fracture, breaking with concentric undulation resembling the growth lines on a shell. Example: quartz, agate, flint, opal, magnesite. The fracture will form like concave structure is called as conchoidal fracture. Hackley fracture, fracture breaking with sharp or jagged surface like wood at times with a jigsaw type. Example: asbestos and gypsum. These are the two minerals gives the Hackley fracture. And the fifth one is earthy fracture, breaking into irregular lumps with smooth or rough surfaces. Example: ochre and bauxite. So the best example for earthy fracture is ochre and the bauxite. Next is hardness. A rock is often called soft because the individual particles, which may be hard in themselves, are loosely held together and readily fall apart. In speaking of minerals, however, hardness means the resistances of the whole surface to being scratched. A century ago, a mineralogist named Friedrich Mohs devised a scale of hardness which is still in use and known as Mohs scale. He placed talc, the softest of all minerals, soft enough to be made into talcum powder. This talc mineral will be used for talcum powder. This is the softest mineral in the Mohs scale. this talk as number one in this series, and diamond, the hardest of all known substances, as number 10. Softest is talc and hardest is diamond. Softest is talc and hardest is diamond. I'll read out the complete scale of Mohs scale. The first softest is talc. Number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like this, in the ascending order, these hardness minerals are arranged in Mohs scale. The first one is talc, number 1. Gypsum is number 2. Calcite is 3. Fluorite is 4. Apatite is 5. Feldspar is 6. Quartz is 7. Topaz is 8. Corundum is 9. And diamond is 10. Like this, the minerals are, standard minerals are arranged in the Mohs scale. Accordingly, we can study and identify the hardness of the given mineral easily. And physical properties of minerals, depending on specific gravity, we can measure the specific gravity of mineral by using the Walker steel add balance instrument. And the physical properties of mineral, depending on certain senses such as taste, feel, and the odor. Taste, the terms used are alkaline, taste of soda, bitter, taste of Epsom salt, cooling, taste of salt, bitter, saline, taste of common salt, sour, taste of sulfuric acid. Feel is the sensation upon touching or handling minerals. The terms used are greasy, soapy, rough, harsh. And the odor, some characteristic smell when rubbed, breathed upon, on heated, the term used are arsenical, like the odor of garlic. Garlic odor, this or pigment mineral will give the garlic smell. And sulfurous, like the odor of burning sulfur. Best example is pyrite. Pyrite will give the burning sulfur odor. Argillaceous, like the odor of clay. Argillaceous means the clay mineral. The best example is ochre. Ochre is the best example for argillaceous, the odor. So these are the physical properties of minerals. Thank you, guys.